Hi, I'm John Keenan. I'm a principal with BRI Ferrier in Sydney. We're specialists in assisting businesses in times of financial distress. I'm here today to continue our BRI Ferrier series on the recently announced small business law reforms. Now, the laws haven't come into effect as yet, but our expectation is they will pass through Parliament and become law as of 1 January 2021, which is obviously very soon. Today, I want to delve into what's involved in the proposed restructuring. The laws themselves are largely based on the US bankruptcy regime, or a voluntary administration in Australia, which is a way of compromising the outstanding creditor claims and allowing the business to continue to trade on should it be viable. Now, as this is a small business initiative, there are certain thresholds that apply. And currently that means that only businesses with liabilities of less than $1 million can access the regime. That is anticipated to carry most of the small businesses in Australia. They also require that the outstanding lodgements and reportings are brought up to date and that the employee entitlements are paid up. Should this be the case, then the business can commence down this restructuring process. Now, it is a debtor-led restructuring, which means that the existing business owners and directors continue to run and trade the business whilst this restructuring goes on. Now, that's a very important concept here and one that we support at BRI Ferrier. In small businesses, the owners know that how to operate their businesses far better than any external professional could be brought in to trade it. And so during this period of 20 business days, those business owners continue to run and control their business, whilst at the same time working with an external practitioner known as a small business restructuring practitioner, being a registered liquidator with experience in distressed times, to come in and develop a plan. That plan aimed at returning the company to financial viability, to compromise the creditor claims over a period of time. The practitioner will assess the plan and develop a report that is issued to the creditors for which they have time to consider. After that period lapses, within 15 days to be precise, the creditors must vote. And if by majority in value they support the plan, then it comes into effect. The business continues to trade and it should hopefully generate the returns required to pay out the creditors quite likely over time. The practitioner sits off to one side and monitors the process and importantly provides and pays those returns to creditors as and when. If the creditors do not approve the plan, if it's rejected, then the business owners need to consider alternate means or mechanisms for them. That might be a voluntary administration or perhaps the simplified liquidation regime, which has been recently announced. We at BRI Ferrier, we have the expertise in these areas. And through this and the following series of videos, we'll explore further what is contemplated in these reforms and be available to assist you in developing a plan to survive this otherwise terrible COVID-19 financial impact. Thank you for your time.